Alright, before we solve this equation for y, let's solve a simpler equation for y. Is that okay with you, Jaden?
Yeah.
That's cool?
Yes.
Okay, how about if you do it for us?
Me?
That's right.
I'm not that smart though.
Yeah, you are.
You forgot
the
extra
savings
like
that. No, I didn't.
I did help. A lot of help.
So, solve that equation on the right for y. On the right, not the left. So on this side we have six ones. The little white tokens represented one when we looked at the scale as we introduced equations. Okay. So the only reason I don't use this is because it has just, there's so much setup to do. Okay, but it's gonna, we're gonna imagine this behaves exactly the same as this would. All right. So on this side we have six of those ones, and on the right side what do we have? You got four of those ones. 1, 2, 3, 4.
And then 9 ones.
9 y's. So how do I show a y?
One.
No, like a box, or like a 9 blocks. Kind of like X was.
Like a little boxy thing. Okay, yeah. So I'll let the box represent a y. And a y could be just anything. It's a wild card. It could be anything at all. Okay? So here's a y, and here's a y, and I'm going to have 9 of these. So I'm going to just draw this real fast with 6 more y's. So I have 9 y, yeah? Now what do you think? If you're trying to figure out what one of these is worth, what might be the very first thing you do, Jaden? Trying to keep both sides of the scale balanced, figure out how much is in one of those things. So if we had a scale like this, right, and we know how that works, like if I wanted to figure out how much this marker was worth, how would I do it? I just have a scale and I just want to figure out how much this marker is worth.
So you just put the marker on one side of the scale and then put your ones, as many ones as it would take on
okay.
The other side.
Yeah, I promise this is going to work out nicely because marker is kind of a, who knows. Okay, so this marker is?
3 ones.
It's 3 ones, right? So you use a scale, it is no different from using an equation. We get the thing that we don't know on one side, things that we do know on the other side, things that we do know are just numbers, okay? We do know that each of these is one, and that three of these makes this level with one of these, then this one thing that we did not know previously is three. The idea is, let's have the things we don't know over here, the mystery, the variable, the unknown, whatever you want to call it, on one side, and then on the other side, balance it out with a number so that we know how much it's worth, right? So now we have a side with unknowns, but it also has other stuff. And on the other side, we have, well, just stuff that we know, just a number, right? Well, it might be something that you try first in order to get your scale to look more like this thing you don't know over here, the variable, the unknown. Just numbers on this side. What would you do with that scale? If the scale looked like that, what would you do to get the variables on one side and the numbers on the other? Let's do it. Dane, come on up. It's got some stuff on this side, got some stuff on that side. What you're trying to do is figure out how much does this work? What would you do?
You would take away.
Go for it. Take a look at the scale over here. Similar, it's got unknown, it's got extra stuff, or it did, right? Extra stuff when you walked out. It's got unknown stuff, extra stuff, and then just regular old stuff over there, just numbers. You don't have to do it all at once, but what's the first thing that you would do? It's very similar to the thing that you did when you came up to this scale. Take away from the unknown side.
So you have to take away the four at once.
There we go. That's the juice right there. So let's just erase it. Right? Get rid of those four. What's happened now, Jaden, that I've erased those four? This can't move, but would it move in real life? How would it move? Almost, but one side would be lower than the other. Which side would be lower than the other?
The unknown.
This side would? I just took four of them away from this side.
There would still be nine unknown things.
Right, but I mean, there's... You know, that set up like this a second ago. With this. Okay. So. Right, but we took these three off. What's going to happen when I take these three off?
It's
going to be lighter. There's less stuff over there, right? So what's going to happen? I just took four from the right side. What's going to happen then?
The left side's going to go up.
The left side's going to go up?
No,
we don't know that.
Down.
The left side's going to go down, right? There's less stuff on the right side, more stuff on the left side. They were balanced. I took stuff from the right side, so the left side should go down.
That's right. Yeah.
And so, what do we need to do to fix that?
We need to even it out.
Subtract.
So we'll take these four from this side as well. These ones, leaving two over here. Right?
Yeah.
Okay. So, this is the exact same thing. What you just did was take four from both sides. Right? Four from both sides. We have now two equals 9y. Right? Thank you, Jaden. Okay, so there's a picture of why we're going to subtract something from both sides, because it's like it's extra weight. We can just take it away. Just pick it up, put it over somewhere else, do the same thing to the left side, get rid of it from both sides. But now we have a kind of a different situation. Look at the scale here. The next thing I would do would be kind of an impossible thing, or a really kind of a difficult thing, because I want to know what just this one is worth. Right? Am I right?
Yeah.
Yeah? I just want to know what this one is worth. So what can we do to both sides? Because I can't really take one of these away, right? Take it, subtract it, because then I would have to subtract that from this side, wouldn't I? I can't do that. I don't have one over here to take away. Or if I did, now it's messing it up. I don't want any y's over here, positive or negative. I don't want them over here. I don't need them over here. Okay. So what's the answer? How are we going to compare one of these to, well, whatever one of those is worth on the left side?
Take them away.
And we just talk about how we can't take them away because there's none to take away over here. If there was a y over here, I would take a y from here and a y from there. Right? because I only want the unknown things on one side of the scale, on one side of the equation. But I don't have any of those. Okay? So whether you look at the equation or you look at the scale, what would you do now to figure out what y was? Just y. Get y by itself. Allie?
Divide.
Divide what?
By 9.
Divide by 9. What's 9 divided by 9?
0.
1.
Or 1.
1. 1 times y. We don't want 0 times y. Divide by 9, we get 2 ninths on this side, so y is 2 ninths. Okay? So, the way that would look is, I can't really take away 8 of these y's, because then I would just subtract 8 of these y's. But, this side is split into how many pieces?
9.
9 pieces.
Y.
There's 9 y's on this side. Well, then I just need to break this up into 9 pieces, right? And look at one of these pieces versus one of these pieces. You see what I mean?
Yeah.
Okay. So I would cut this into 9 pieces and this into 9 pieces and see what it looks like once I've done that. So I cut this into 9ths. This is not going to look good. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Let's say I cut it into 9ths. And let's say this is in 9ths. So I cut this into 9 pieces and this into 9 pieces, okay? Well, if I look at this guy and this guy together, they make up 1/9 of this side, 1/9 of this side is one of these, 1/9 of this side is 2 of these little guys. Okay? That's 1/9 of this, that's 1/9 of this. 2/9. We divided the 2 into 9 pieces and looked at a comparison between 1/9 of this side and 1/9 of this side. Cut into 9 pieces, cut into 9 pieces. Now let's just do that again real quick without all the scales and stuff. So I subtract 4 from both sides. Because I just want the variable by itself.
2.
Divide by 9. Because I want 1/9 of this side. 9 divided by 9 is 1. I have a 1y equals 2 ninths.
Can you just put y?
Yes. 1 times y is y. Just write it like that. Okay, now this equation is very similar. Still want to get y by itself. There's still stuff added to it. There's still stuff multiplied by it. We're going to do something really similar, Olivia.
Which one is that? What?
This is number 7. This isn't anything to do with the homework except for to show you how we're going to approach this problem. In the same way that I subtracted 4 from both sides and then divided by 9, look here, I'm taking 9y and I'm adding 4x. So I will subtract 4x from both sides. Just like you subtracted 4 from here, 4 from both sides, we're going to subtract 4x from both sides. Why? Because 4x is being added to 9y. We've got 9y, plus we have 4x. We'll subtract the 4x, and we'll just be left with 9y, because 4x minus 4x is 0. On the left side, we've got 6 minus 4x. In the same way that we divide by 9, we divide by 9 here, because we want to get 9 divided by 9 is 1y. Divide by 9 on the other side, because if we didn't, then both sides would not be equal. Be all off. There it is. It's not a good looking answer, but it is the only answer that could work. The only other thing I could do is to rewrite it so it looks different. James and Mac, pay attention, please. Okay. I could divide 6 by 9, I could divide negative 4 by 9 and write it a little differently, but it's still going to be equal to this, 6 minus 4x over 9. Here's a little formula. Let me tell you what it does. It's 273.1. Okay. So if you take some temperature from a thermometer, okay. So we take this temperature, and it's in degrees C, which we wouldn't really use degrees C, we use Fahrenheit, but if you're in most other countries, they'll use Celsius. We would plug that temperature in there at 272.15, and that would tell us what temperature it is in a scale called Kelvin. Is a really scientific measuring system. Okay, it's kind of like the metric of temperatures. So if this temperature read, or this thermometer read 80 degrees, and it was in Celsius, I would just plug 80 in there for Celsius at 273.15, and that would be the same as 353.15 in Kelvin. Okay. But if I were to give you Kelvin, like 30 Kelvin,
30 Kelvin,
can you figure out how much that is in Celsius?
Oh yeah, I know. Never mind.
How would we figure out what Celsius, how much
minus
it is? Colby, so what would we do to figure out what how much it is in Celsius?
Subtract.
Subtract what?
30.
Subtract 30. What's 30 minus 30?
Zero.
273.15 minus 30 is 243.13.
I got the
game. Did that do it for us?
No.
Well, let's go from where we are. What would we do now to figure out what Celsius is, what C is? Subtract C. Okay, what's C minus C?
C.
C minus C.
One. Zero C.
Zero C, or zero, which C is 243.13. And what's zero minus C?
C.
Zero.
Zero minus C.
Negative C.
Okay, we're getting kind of closer. Negative C is 243.13, but I want to know what C is, not what negative C is. But if negative C is a positive 243.13, then what would C have to be?
-243.13.
So it'd have to be a negative for the negative of the negative to be positive. Or we could divide by negative 1 on both sides. Divide C to negative 243.
Wait, so that's the answer?
That would be what C is if K were 30. If we're talking about 30 Kelvin, then C would be negative 243.15. Maybe a little bit of a faster route, a direct route there. It would be if we subtract 273.15 from both sides. 30 minus 273.15, negative 243.15. Now, if I keep giving you measurements in Kelvin, you could keep solving for C over and over and over, okay? But, you know, there's always this step of subtracting 273.15 from both sides every time, right? See what I mean? So what we do, if we were in that kind of a situation, rather than continuing to plug something in for K and subtract 273 from both sides, forget about all that. Let's just get C by itself before we ever do any plugging in of Kelvin. So if I want to get C by itself, we would subtract 273.15 from both sides. K minus 273.15. That's how I would find C. Doing that gets C by itself. Cancels out the 273.15. We have K minus 273.15 is C. Now, if, as in part B, they tell us that there's a temperature of 300 Kelvin, how many degrees Celsius is that? How will we figure out? This goes from Celsius to Kelvin, and this could go from Kelvin to Celsius. You just plug that in there. K is 300. The formula we just wrote is minus 273.15 from K. And
26.8 something.
It's what? 26.8. That's how many degrees in Celsius is the same as 300 Kelvin. What's freezing in Celsius?
30.
That's Fahrenheit.
Oh. Zero.
Zero in Celsius is the freezing point of water. And in Celsius, 100 is boiling water. So this is below freezing, right? No, I got it mixed up myself. 26.85, well, it's kind of chilly, 26.85. It's 26.85 degrees Celsius above freezing. That's 300 in Kelvin. Okay. So from that we could maybe kind of conclude that Kelvin is made to measure really, really cold things, because you don't get zero Kelvin. If Celsius was zero, that would only be, I don't know, in the 200s for Kelvin. So zero in Kelvin is called absolute zero, and it's never been achieved. Nobody's ever gotten anything to be zero Kelvin. Zero Kelvin. You know what makes things hot? What makes things cold?
Other hot things.
Okay, you're just being next to a hot thing, but what is it about an object that makes it hot?
Oh my god,
wait, it's called absolute zero?
I'm asking a question here. What about my coffee makes what about coffee or any hot thing makes it hot? What is going on with that thing?
Heat. Fire
and hotness makes it hot is not a good explanation.
Water.
Boiling water.
Radioactive.
Not like what?
Radioactive.
I'm not looking for answers like a stove, an oven. I'm saying what about the object makes it hot?
Absolute heat.
The water.
And
it contracts in the
heat.
The temperature.
What about
the boiling
point? The water makes hot.
The thing that makes what's
physical change.
It's your coffee.
Flammability.
Rub your hands together.
Friction.
Okay. Now there's not a set of coffee hands when you're running together, right?
Why not? It's gotta make
ow.
It's the what about what's frictioning against other things in here?
Your coffee beans.
The molecule. The molecules in there are essentially. The molecules in there are bumping up against each other, releasing energy, making things hot. Molecules moving quickly makes things hot. So what makes things cold?
Cold molecules.
Slowly, okay? So absolute zero, zero Kelvin, is so cold that the molecules are so slow that they're not moving at all. No movement whatsoever. But no one's ever done it. Most people think it'll never happen. It'll never get to zero Kelvin. But that gives you an idea of what Kelvin is. It's just based on the idea of absolute zero, the temperature where all the molecules in an object would just stop moving altogether. No little vibrations, nothing. Just no movement. We do some really cool things with really, really cool temperatures, but nobody's ever gotten zero Kelvin.
So absolute zero.
That's what absolute zero means. Molecules cease to move. So when we have equations that have more than one kind of variable, we do the same thing in that equation with the other variable as we would with numbers in another equation, like this one. I have 9y, essentially 9y plus 4. I would subtract the 4 because I want to cancel out that 4. Same thing here, 9y plus 4x. I want to cancel out that 4x, so I subtract 4x. Here's what I'm going to do, because I don't know how to reach you guys. I'm doing everything I can think of. That. Oh, whatever. I'm just going to solve a bunch of these equations over and over and over. You copy them, and see if that works. Okay? I want to solve for x. See, I'll solve this equation twice. I'll solve it once for x and once for y. Here we go. Solving for x. I have 5x plus. I'm adding 2y. Right? I don't want 2y. I just want x. So how do I cancel out an adding of 2y? Yes?
Subtract 2y.
Subtract 2y. 2y minus 2y is nothing, so there's nothing left. 3 minus 2y is
1
minus 2y. Unlike terms, combine. Here I have 5x divided by 5, because 5 divided by 5 is 1. That's what I like. I like a 1x with nothing added onto it. So 3 minus 2y is 5. Should be an equal sign. Do it again, but solve it for y. 5x plus 2y equals 3. Well, now I'm going to look at this more like 2y plus 5x. 2y plus 5x, how do I cancel out a plus 5x? Kelly?
What?
How do I cancel out the plus 5x?
U minus 5x.
Minus 5x. 5x minus 5x is?
1x.
No.
0.
0x.
Yeah.
Minus 5x on the other side. 3 and 5x are not like terms, so we just get
3
minus 5x.
What?
Now I have 2 times y. How do I cancel out the multiplication of 200?
Then you divide by both sides too.
Divide by 2 on both sides. 2 divided by 2 is 1. 1y is great.
3
minus
5x
over
2
is y.
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
So
we again, x plus 4y equals 2. Solve for x. Actually, let's make it at least a little bit different than last time. Let's make it a minus. Okay, so I'm going to solve for x. Solve for x. Got 7x minus 4y equals 2. I don't want 7x minus 4y. It would be great if I had 7x by itself. Plus 4y, what's negative 4y plus 4y? 0. Plus 4y.
7x
minus 2 plus.
Divide by 7.
Divide by 7.
X.
Plus 4y, the whole thing divided by. Now let's solve for y. Okay, so now we have 7x minus 4y equals was 2, so I might want to look at it more like 4, negative 4y plus 7x. So just like Jaden did for us earlier, right? We had 3 extra things over here with the marker. And the first thing we did was to take the stuff that wasn't marker off of that marker side, right? We only want y stuff on this side to start with, so let's get rid of this x stuff by subtracting 7x, subtracting 7x. Negative 4y equals 2 minus 7x.
Divide by 4.
Divide by negative 4.
Negative 4.
Y equals
2 minus 7x over negative 4.
We can go back. What should we do first?
Y.
Let's solve for y. Negative 3y plus 4x equals 7. Solving for y. I don't want anything that's not y on this side. Let's start
so
with
minus 4x on both sides.
Minus 4x minus 4x.
And then it's 3, negative 3, 1,
3. Y, 4x minus 4x is 0.
0.
7 minus 4x is what we have over here.
And then divide by negative.
Negative 3 divided by negative 3 is a positive 1. That's exactly what I want. 7 minus 4x over negative 3. Now we'll solve for x. Negative 3y plus 4x equals 7. Now I will not rewrite the order of this. I'm just going to recognize that I have a 4x and I am subtracting 3y from it. Subtracting 3y from 4x.
Yeah.
3y cancel out the subtracting of 3y. Let's add 3y. If I add 3y, if I subtract 3y from that, I'll have 0. So on this side, I'll have 4x. Add 3y to this side, and we get 7 plus 3y. Divide by 4. Now you try. Y equals 12. Solve for y. All right, solving for y. That's the things that are not y things, right? Let's get y by itself.
Minus 5 on both sides, and then that's well, minus 5 there, on one side, wait, it's 0 on this, so 5 minus 5 is 0, or 5, positive 5 minus, or, what am I doing, 0, and then 12,
5x minus 5 is 0,
5x minus 5 is 0.
You're adding.
5x minus 5.
5x minus 5.
5x, different. Okay, very good. 5x minus 5x certainly is 0x.
So it's negative 2y equals 12, negative, 12 minus 5x.
Good.
And then divide by 2 on both sides. And then that's equals y equals 12, 12 minus.
What's negative 2 divided by 2?
1.
Negative 1.
Negative 1.
Negative 1. We don't want a negative 1, why do we?
So it's plus. It's a plus 4, 5, x.
Oh, negative
2. Negative 2 divided by negative 2 is a positive 1, why?
So 12 minus
5. Minus 5.
Negative
some add 5x's. So let me just take this over to next page. How about that? Now, this is a 5x to a positive 5x. If I did rewrite the order, it would become even a little more clear that the thing I'm trying to get by itself has a 5x being added to it. So I would subtract 5x. If I added 5x to this, 5x plus 5x would be 10x.
Get out here.
The reason I've written this up here is just to show you that we do definitely subtract 5x to start, not add 5x to start. Subtract 5x.
Yeah.
Five.
Thank you.